The Marvel Comics character Ghost Rider had been a film project that lay dormant in Hollywood hell since the early 1990s. Helmed by Daredevil director Mark Steven Johnson, the film adaptation of Ghost Rider, starring Nicolas Cage, finally went into production during early 2003, but wasn't released until February 2007, a long four-year process due to further various development issues. Though the film was plagued with negative reviews from critics and was received poorly by fans, it grossed enough at the box office to be considered a financial success that enabled the sequel to be put into production, whether audiences wanted one or not. Mad About Superheroes presents Comic Book Movie Flashback, Ghost Rider, Spirit of Vengeance. In 2007, Marvel producer Avi Arad announced the development of Ghost Rider 2 at a press event, to which Peter Fonda had expressed an interest in returning as Mephistopheles. Ultimately, Fonda would not return to the franchise. Nicolas Cage also expressed interest in returning to the title role of Ghost Rider. In an interview, Cage went on further to mention that he would enjoy seeing a darker interpretation, stating, "He's not eating jelly beans anymore, he's getting drunk." Cage also suggested that the film could possibly feature newly created villains. It was also rumored that the sequel would feature Danny Ketch, another Marvel character who takes up the Ghost Rider mantle in the comics. In 2012, the sequel to Ghost Rider was released in theaters with the subtitle Spirit of Vengeance. The second installment did indeed attempt a darker approach. The rumors of Danny Ketch appearing were true, but instead of a young man, Danny makes his film debut as a young boy and does not assume the Ghost Rider persona. Nick Cage is of course back to chew up the scenery as the Spirit of Vengeance with his usual infamous antics. The story begins in Romania, where a French priest named Moreau warns the monks of a monastery about an impending attack by the devil's forces to obtain a boy named Danny. Moreau tries to help the boy and his mother Nadia escape, but the distrusting mother shoots Moreau and flees with her son. Moreau manages to distract the men chasing Danny and Nadia, but nearly dies in the process and loses them. He believes that only the Ghost Rider is capable of protecting the boy. 8 years have passed since Johnny Blaze became the Ghost Rider. Driven into hiding, Blaze fights the evil spirit within him. Moreau finds him and convinces Blaze to save the boy in exchange for his priesthood's ability to restore Johnny's soul and remove the Ghost Rider curse.
Zarathos was an angel, a spirit of justice. Sent to protect the world of men, but he was tricked, captured, brought down to hell, corrupted. Driven insane.
His mission to protect the innocent was perverted into a lust to punish the guilty. He became the spirit of vengeance.
Crank film series directors Mark Navaldine and Brian Taylor bring a distinctive style and fast-paced energy to the sequel that slightly elevates its entertainment value over its predecessor, but not enough to prevent it from being an incohesive mess. Both the visuals and subject matter of Spirit of Vengeance are grittier in tone than the previous installment, but akin to its predecessor, attempts at humor often don't achieve the desired effect. And though some action scenes are executed brilliantly with impressive computer-generated imagery and daring death-defying stunts, others are a jumble of a shaky cam mess. Cage can be unintentionally funny at times, but doesn't help the darker approach being attempted by constantly hamming up his performance. Idris Elba and Christopher Lambert are great actors and turn in their best efforts. Unfortunately, their talents are wasted, given little to nothing to do. The rest of the cast also does the best with what they're given. It's just unfortunate that the script gives them very little by way of character development, favoring style over substance and action set pieces over a more compelling story. I also think the film lacks a strong villain. That's not a slight on those actors. I just would have liked to have seen Nightmare, or Vengeance from the comics as the main threats. Cage said in 2013 he believes another Ghost Rider film might happen down the road, saying it would be interesting if they did it with a female Ghost Rider. Before Marvel Studios and the Marvel Cinematic Universe as we know it today, back in the late 80s, early 90s, Marvel was confident enough in their respective properties to believe they'd be as ripe for a transition from page to screen as DC Comics' Batman and Superman, who are both proven bankable commodities at the box office. In desperation to make it to the big screen, Marvel sold the film rights to some of their most lucrative characters to various film studios. The X-Men and the Fantastic Four wound up at 20th Century Fox, and Spider-Man and Ghost Rider ended up at Sony. Marvel Studios president Kevin Feige announced on May 2, 2013, the film rights to Ghost Rider had reverted back to Marvel Studios, though he also stated that the studio had no immediate plans to remake another Ghost Rider film. Which is too bad. I've always been a big fan of Ghost Rider, and though I wasn't entirely pleased with the two installments released, I think Ghost Rider deserves a reboot, and would be interested to see Ghost Rider returning to theaters under the direction of Marvel Studios.
Not afraid of you.
We should be.
What if you have to pee while you're on fire?
Oh, that's awesome.
I hope you enjoyed this installment of Comic Book Movie Flashback. Thanks for letting your geek flag fly with Mad About Superheroes. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and check out these other cool videos right here on Mad About Superheroes.